Juan Pedro Baigorri Velar was an Argentine inventor, known for having supposedly invented the rain machine in the 1930s and was said to have caused rain amidst a drought. He was born in Concepción del Uruguay and raised in Buenos Aires. He traveled to Italy, where he received his degree in engineering and specialized in geophysics at the University of Milan and then settled in Argentina. Originally, Velar planned to make a device capable of finding the underground water sources and Earth's electromagnetic conditions by generating electromagnetic emissions. When newspaper Crítica journalists approached Velar for inquiring about his invention, then he stated, in 1926, while working in Bolivia in the search for minerals using an apparatus of my invention, I noticed something curious. When I connected the mechanism and it started up, there was a light rain that prevented me from working. I was struck by the phenomenon and considered that these small rains could be caused by the electromagnetic congestion that the irradiation of my machine produced in the atmosphere. His claim was based on the various studies and practicals he has done on his instruments to make it rain in different areas. Convinced of the efficacy of his invention, the engineer decided to publicize it. Baigorri approached the manager of Central Argentine Railway, Mr. Mac Ray, to verify that his equipment was effective. The manager then sarcastically asked Velar to make it rain in Santiago del Estero, an area suffering from worst drought conditions and had been without significant rainfall for 3 years. Instead of being skeptical, Velar enthusiastically accepted the invitation and left for it. The rain apparatus consisted of a 14-inch television panel, an electric battery for the energy required to operate, a mixture of radioactive metals reinforced by the introduction of chemical compounds, and two opposite charged poles. The antennas sent the electromagnetic radiation released by the metals in the device to the sky to increase the density of charged particles in the atmosphere in a concentrated region, prompting rainfall in the same locality. He was accompanied by Hugo Mietello, who traveled as a company representative and a witness to the experiment. Both arrived in the city with a clear sky and the bright sun. What Mietello witnessed was unbelievable. According to Mietello, minutes after Velar started the machine, the wind changed direction, and the sky gradually became cloudy and it started raining after a few hours of the machine operation. However, not satisfied with the amount of rainfall, Velar pursued the creation of a more powerful system. Governor Pio Montenegro issued them the province's farm school, and after 55 hours of operation, the machinery ended 3 years of drought with a storm lasting 11 hours and downpouring 60 millimeters of water over the capital of Santiago. Velar was said to have caused enough rain to bring back an old lagoon in Carhu town. He was already a hero when he returned to Buenos Aires, and several newspapers wrote and interviewed him about the incident. It was such a sensation that the London-based The Times contacted him over the telephone. Velar, however, had to face scientific skepticism and criticism over his invention. Alfredo Galmarini, the head of Directorate of Meteorology, also criticized Velar, citing that it was a mere coincidence. After that, there was a tussle of heated comments from both sides. Finally, this tussle brought Velar to comment, "In response to the censorship of my procedure, I will give rain to Buenos Aires on January 3, 1939. Crítica published this note, signed by Velar on the 27th of December, and this challenge became the hottest topic in the city. Millions were looking to the sky and betting whether or not it would rain. On December 30th, Velar activated his machine, and expectations were set high. He was so convinced that he sent an umbrella to Director of Meteorology with a note which read, to be used on the 2nd of January. Velar said he would regulate the machine to avoid things from getting out of control, and it will rain between the 2nd and 3rd of January. Amazingly, heavy rainfall was observed on the dawn of January 2nd. After this success, he continued with his work and ended droughts in many areas. He also made it possible to cause rain in a rural area of San Juan in 1951, where rain had not fallen in 8 years. Despite all of that, he had to withdraw since he declined to disclose the basis on which his invention worked. He also turned down an offer from an American engineer to patent his device. This led to a suspicion that all of his work could be a scientific fraud. Eduardo Piacentini, of the National Meteorological Service, believed that the Velar's apparatus could be able to detect but not cause rain. In 1972, Velar died almost engulfed in poverty, and died with him the secret of rain-making machine. So this is it for this video, friends. Thanks for watching. But before you leave, let me know what you guys think about this rain wizard and his mysterious rain-making machine. Did he really made a real rainmaking machine, or was it just a mere coincidence? If you like the video, then press the like button, share this video with your friends and family, and subscribe to this channel for more such interesting content.